Hello, my name is Joseph Puckett, and I'm with Craig Wiggins, Allstate Insurance Agencies. And here I have my very good client and now friend, Jan Owen. And she is here today with a very special message for all of you who are watching this video. My hope is that it can just help at least one person, at least one family. And she's going to tell you her life insurance story. So, Jan, tell us your life insurance story and what we've done together.
Well, in the fall of 2012, we decided to do a life insurance checkup. And really, my husband was quite resistant. He thought we had handled this, no need to go back over it. And I talked him into it. I kind of bullied him. And we came in and we sat down with Joseph. And we had never met you. That was our first appointment with you. And so we went over what we might need, and we got that settled, and we, you know, bought some what we thought we would need. We thought bought the amount we thought would be good for us. Our children are grown. We didn't, we didn't foresee there being a big need for a huge amount, but we bought what we thought would be needful. Well, it was approved. The policy was approved, I believe, in the middle of January.
Mm-hmm. About 2 years ago today.
Yeah, mm-hmm. two years ago, and about mid-January, we got the letter, and that was a relief. And then, at the end of January, the last day of January, my husband was in Birmingham, and he went to the bathroom and urinated blood and went to the emergency room, and they said, you have kidney cancer. Well, a series of events happened. We went to doctor after doctor, found out that he'd spread all over his body. I went to MD Anderson, and they said, you have maybe 2 years to live. And so this was obviously quite unexpected. My husband was not sick. He very rarely went to the doctor. He seemed perfectly healthy. Honestly, he went to the doctor much less than I ever have. But, you know, you just don't know. It's just the lesson to me that you just don't know. Well, we had this life insurance policy. And honestly, when they told us at MD Anderson, the doctor looked at Phil and said, you have maybe 2 years. We went out of the office. Didn't even get to the car, and Phil calls Joseph because he wants to make sure the premiums are paid, everything's in order. And he looked at me that day, and I still, you know, it still makes me cry because he left me taken care of, well taken care of. But he looked at me and he said, you know, I just wish I had bought more. I wish I had done more. And anyway, it's expensive to be sick. I did not work. I was a missionary, and so I had very little income, and obviously I had to quit doing that to take care of him. And we had a lot of expenses, and so we actually were able to get an advance on one of the policies, and that was wonderful because I paid off all debt, except for the house. I paid off my car. We were able to make sure all our children had a reasonable car. We were able to take trips together. We were just able to cover some expenses since I couldn't work. Mm-hmm. And so that was a real gift. And honestly, it was because of that policy that I had a little money in the bank when Phil passed away. If I had not had what was left over from that, I would have had $1,000 in the bank. That's all I would have had left.
Right.
Because it was just... So, especially even the last weeks of life, I had to fly my kids home. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of things come up. So.
And you mentioned when we were talking before that, you know, people say, well, I have health insurance, right? There's a lot of things that health insurance won't cover.
No.
Right? Like you're talking trips and gas and running this and that, co-pays and expenses for the family, putting people up in hotel rooms, buying food because, you know, you might not feel like cooking that night.
Right. Well, when I brought the kids home, when he went to a hospice facility and we knew that it was just a matter of days, I spent several thousand dollars getting a plane ticket at the last minute. None of my children have jobs with benefits, so trying to help them pay for, you know, we're all, obviously nobody's cooking. We're camped out here, so you're having to, you know, run, get food for everybody all the time. Now, just a lot of different things. Things that you don't really think about. Even help at the house. I couldn't get the grass mowed, you know, things like that. Just little things that make life easier.
Absolutely.
And so, and then once Phil passed away and I got the death certificate, I came in on a Thursday and I deposited the check the next Friday.
Yeah, it was about a week before we had your money.
Right. And that was really fast because we have life insurance as well through the government. And that's wonderful. It's wonderful to have employer, you know, life insurance, but it takes a lot longer.
Absolutely does. And what we always tell our clients here is get as much as you can at work. Get it. It's cheap. It's easy to approve. Get as much as you can at work, but a lot of times you're not going to use it while you're working.
Right.
And if you leave, such as a friend that you have, you know, who no longer works at a place that provided life insurance, he's gone.
Yeah.
You know, now it's going to be so much more expensive
right.
to get what he needs outside of work.
Yes, and you don't really, you want to make sure, to me, it's a gift. It's a gift to those you leave behind. And now as the recipient of that gift, it's something I've made sure that is there for my children, even, because I know how helpful it is, how important it is. I understand better the expenses that can crop up, and especially if you've made the decision for your wife not to work mm-hmm. for many years, to stay home, take care of children, to me, it's just not fair to put her in the position of not having that mm-hmm. when the time comes.
Yeah. Everyone thinks they're going to live forever. You know you're not.
No.
Right? You're not going to live forever. If you're watching this video and you haven't talked with someone about your life insurance plan, you have to. And as you just said, it's not for you.
Right.
It's for your spouse. It's for your kids. It's for your grandkids. Mm-hmm. It's one of the most selfless things you can ever do, putting this little chunk of money every month away into this important policy that I hope you never need. You are going to die, but I hope you don't die while you have this policy. I hope you live till you're 150 years old. But you need to do this.
Mm-hmm.
It's not for you. It's for your family. And I remember meeting with Phil in the office two doors down, just right down this hall, in December. And he's a big guy, mm-hmm. you know, jovial. And we had to talk him into it.
Yes.
I remember this.
We did.
I'm going to live forever.
Mm-hmm. I'm healthy. You know, like
two
I said,
months later. Yeah.
He went to the doctor for yearly checkups. That was pretty much it. I have like five specialists that I have to go see.
Yeah.
he would go to the doctor once or twice a year, mainly for checkups.
Mm-hmm.
And just a very rare, aggressive, incurable form of cancer. By the time we found out about it, it was stage four.
Well, I'm very happy to have some silver lining to this cloud,
yeah.
you know, that we were able to meet. And that we were able to talk, and that we were able to make a plan, and that we were able to talk him into doing it, because walking out of that doctor's office, you know, at least he knew that there was some coverage there, and he called me, and we've worked together a lot the past year and a half,
mm-hmm.
a lot, and hopefully this video will help give someone else some courage to talk to their insurance agent and say, hey, let's talk about this,
mm-hmm.
because you're a perfect example of what went right.
Right.
There are so many examples of what went wrong.
Yes.
People pass away and leave nothing. They can't even bury them. They're passing around a hat, let alone put food on the table, put a roof over their heads. A lot of people die with nothing.
Right. I can't tell you how many people have told me a story mm-hmm. of being widowed or someone they knew that was widowed who lost their home.
Oh, my gosh.
Because it was a woman who had maybe mm-hmm. never worked or not worked much, and then all of a sudden, you know, they don't have enough income. They don't have enough money to make a house payment. One woman told me she hid in her house for 3 months because she said just creditor after creditor
right.
came calling and she had nothing, no way to pay the bills. And, you know, we had some warning.
Mm-hmm.
But I do have a very close friend that died in October of a heart attack and they had no warning.
Right.
And they were a little bit older than us, but not much. They weren't. I mean, he was 65, his wife was 60, not old. And so, just, you know, you just don't know what life will hold. And that's a truth that I have had to, had to stare in the face. So.
Well, you've been fantastic throughout this whole process, and I'm just thankful that we've been able to help you some. And I hope this video helps one of you. Jan, this was Jan's idea. Okay, to tell her story, and she's very brave, and I love you very much for doing this, because if it even just helps one family,
yeah,
that could be so life-changing for
yes.
that family.
Yes, you think about it. I told my cousin, she actually emailed mm-hmm. me after Phil died and said, well, how much do you think we need? And I was like, I'm not an insurance agent, but I said, you've got two little boys
oh, yes.
that have not gone through college,
mm-hmm.
you have, I know you're working, but you know, not enough to support if something happens to Bradley. And so I said, this is, you know, an opportunity for you to go in. And I, at your age, I would get over $1 million is what I told her. I said, I would go get whatever I could. But you think about college, you think about all the expenses of a young child, of having young children. My children are grown, and there's enough expenses. But young children, that's really a big deal.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, thank you again for being brave and telling this story to everybody. No problem. Please share this video with your friends, your family, your coworkers. Share it, okay? This is really, really powerful stuff. And I appreciate you very much.
Thank you, Joseph.
Yes, thank you.
That'd be wonderful.